What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my laboratory, where safety is number one priority. And today I'm going to show you 5 very unique trench lighters. Let's see what they're all about. Let's see what we got here first. This is old school lighters, but have been redone or rebuilt. So check this out. You just pull this up, that's it, and pull this down to close it. Let me show it to you guys again. Up and down. As you can see, it's brand new lighter, never been used. So what we'll have to do to refill it is open it like that and fill it up with the lighter fluid. Got my regular lighter fluid and pour some till it gets pretty soaked up. That looks good. And then close this side here. Then don't forget to close it and put it far away once you're going to test this lighter. So that way the whole thing don't light up. Okay, and let's see how this lighter works. Lift it up, put it to the side. Looks like it's moist wick. Boom. And it's going to burn from the side this way or this way. How cool is that? And to close it, just close it like that. So it's one of those oil or gas lighters. How cool is this? That is so unique. If you hold it like that, it barely burning, but if you hold it to the side, it burning a lot. Obviously, I just added the oil. Once extra burn off, it won't be that much flame, but it is so comfortable to hold it. I love it. I wonder what this is. Oh, okay, this side here is to replace the flint and a spring inside here, so you would spin it to unscrew it and open it. This is the first trench lighter in this kind of design that I own, and I love it. Such a good idea, one of a kind. Okay, let's see what else I have. So this is pretty sure reproduction lighters. They could have been invented a long time ago. But anyways, there's extra flint. And let me show you what this is all about. Looks like one of those zipper lighters. But definitely very old school and redundant. How do you start it? Usually you would press it right here to start it, and the spinner in the middle right here, so you wouldn't be able to start it anyways. So you press it right here, and as you can see, it lights up. Can you see the spark? It sparks every time. It is out of oil, so let's get a screwdriver, open it up, and put some oil in. I can't find my screwdriver, but it's okay because back of the fork will work. They designed this screw to be really, really thick. Assuming you don't have a screwdriver, you can use pretty much anything to open it up. And this is where you're going to get lighter fluid. Right here is to replace your striker. So very, very unique design. As you can see, you just spin right here and it slides up. But at the same time, it opens and spins it with one flick. Such a cool design. Okay, let's add on lighter fluid. It's a brand new lighter as well. That should be enough. Again, move this to the side. Okay, let's strike it. Boom. Okay, finally, it's got some oil in it. Very nice, I love it. Every time lights up now. Definitely one of a kind lighter, don't you guys think? With one hand, no problem. Such a unique design. I never seen a design like that, where you have opener and striker on one side like that. Definitely going into my collection. Okay, let's see what else we got here. This is a wooden box. Then I even forgot what I have ordered. Oh, cool. This is a really nice trench lighter. You can open it like that, close it. This is like a wind guard. And then just stack it like that. Okay, let's fill it up with lighter fluid. Very simple. I like the big opening, because it's much easier not to spill it. With that other one, I was spilling quite a bit actually. Okay, that looks soaked. Then we're gonna close it. And there's also a little screwdriver opening. And first of all, I'm gonna light it like that. Boom. Lights really, really easily. Also, you can close the guard. So in case there is heavy wind, you can close it or open it. Up to you. But it works both ways. There you go. Such a unique design, I love this. Works every time. And then here you can open this screw up, and that way you can replace the striker. Okay, let's see what else I have here. What is this? How does this work? I have no idea. Where is the striker? Like that? Okay, to the side right here. That is one of a kind. And this side here, I guess if you take it out, you replace your sparker. So very, very simple. Wow, that's very unique lighter. So you would hold this lighter like that, open it, and then strike it like that. Not the other way around, this way only. Okay, let's refill it. Once again, we need a fork. Or a screwdriver, even better, but I don't have one. Okay, and then we're going to fill it. This smaller opening is a bit harder to see how much I have filled. That's definitely good. It'll get soaked up. Ah, definitely too much. It leaked out from the other side. Okay, now let's see how this lighter works. Hold it like that, strike it. The striker to this side, that's definitely one of a kind lighter right here. Let me show you from the other side. You open it and then you strike it. Open it, strike it. Such a unique lighter, don't you guys think? Definitely goes into my collection too. Okay, let's see what else we got here. Oh, this is a tiny one. This I'm pretty sure like an oil holder or gas holder, lighter fluid holder, depends what you're using for your lighter. And you have a tiny lighter like that, and it's waterproof because this is supposed to be a rubber seal inside there. It comes with extra rubbers in case they go bad. Boom. So, and to refill it, you just hold it like that and unspin it. Actually, it kind of comes out, but wiggle it and spin it kind of works. Then get your lighter fluid and we'll fill it up from the back. I like this lighter because it's so tiny, and I don't think lighter fluid will go bad. A lot of times those other type of lighters, lighter fluid will evaporate. With this one, I don't think it will, because look how well and tight it sits. So hopefully it will keep everything inside there. But time will only tell how awesome this lighter is. Okay, let's light it up. Boom, there's a little bit extra of oil. And the only way to put it out, I guess, to just cover it or just blow it out. But I love it. It's definitely super tiny. Whenever you're done, you just close it off. Okay, and I have one more. Let's see what this one does. Boom. This one is simpler design. That's it. Instead of having different opening, it's almost like a Zippo lighter, except the top is very, very different, as you can see. So it's not Zippo lighter at all. Let's open it up. Very easy. Whoa, look at that opening. So hopefully this one will hold the oil really well too. Boom. That's it. You don't even have to unscrew anything. I really love this lighter, the way this design. And this screw right here to replace the flint. And then just close it. And it's pretty tight. That's it. And now you can put this in. Open it. Light it. Close it. That is nice. works every time. I like it. And the best part, again, because they have this kind of seal, the oil will last a lot longer. At least that's what I assume. Hopefully this seals also really, really well inside there. And I think it does, because there is a little rubber inside there too. So a lot of those regular Zippo lighters lose, or the gas will evaporate after a while. Hopefully this one, the gas or lighter fluid does not evaporate ever and last for very, very long time. Well guys, that's pretty much it. Let me know in comments below what do you think about this video. Don't forget to thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you next time.